how to communicate with your customers without saying a word. Now, sometimes I'm a bit harsh with my clients, and I tell them that every email, every conversation, every call from a customer, all of those are defects. If we want to be critical, we can consider each of those types of communication a defect, because potentially you could have communicated exactly what was asked in that meeting, exactly what was asked in that call, more effectively. Now, I love the term visuality. Visuality, the language of visual things, right? The language of visual signals and controls. If I show you a red circle, you're going to get the feeling that we should stop. If I show you footprints on the ground, you're going to get the feeling that you should follow them. These are ways that someone is communicating something to you, and they didn't even have to speak a word. Now, what's awesome for you is the more that you have these available, the more that you use these, the less you have to take calls from your customers, the less you have to have these questions from your employees, the easier it is for them to do it right and the harder it is for them to do it wrong. Airports are a fantastic example of these signals. They have lines on the ground for the plane to follow. If you watch them take this plane across a line, and it even has marks for the type of plane that it is, where it should stop. The person on the ground has lights and a vest so that that person can see them without having to speak to them. They know what they're saying. In the airport, from the time that you walk in, there is signage everywhere with arrows, with pictures, so that you can navigate to food, you can navigate to your gate without having to go to the information desk. Now, sometimes we do have to go to the information desk. And if you're working at an airport, I would challenge you to write down the questions that people ask, because if you know what they're asking, you can identify maybe a coffee cup doesn't tell everybody where food is. Maybe gate C11 isn't as clear as you think it is, right? So you can identify some of those gaps in your communication. Visuality, communicating without saying a word. Now, this can be physical spaces, but this can be virtual spaces as well. So you might have some conditional formatting that you can do to make it clear if a value is not correct or does not look to be within a certain range. You can automate things so that that you take people exactly where you want them, so that they don't have to click 18 times to get to the point that they want to get to. Now, as I said, if we're being critical, each email, each call could be considered a defect. So think about all the ways that you're currently communicating, how you can make it visual, how you could automate a response, how you could make it really easy for that person to understand the answer to that question without you having to speak a word.